So I've spent my entire 28-year career with USGS working on environmental mercury contamination. I was one of a very fortunate few people back in the mid to late 1980s that got involved with trying to unravel a mystery that was laid out back then, and that was, how can the most remote, pristine lakes in northern Wisconsin have very surprisingly high levels of mercury in their fish when there was no proximal or known source that we could think of? That project largely led to the discovery that atmospheric mercury was the most important source leading to the contamination of fish in these very pristine situations. And back then, however, we couldn't understand what the pathways were that got to these remote systems, what the most important sources were, and ultimately, would they change in time if we could ever accomplish regulation of those emission sources.